We bring in our good friend, Wally Szczerbiak, on the MSG 150 speed dial presented by Fios by Verizon. Wally Ball, you're not on a golf course. You're here talking with us. So it's a rarity that we get to see you. But how you doing, man?
I'm doing good. Doing very well. This series has been tremendous. Feel bad for KD. Just really tough news for him and the Warriors. But I'm excited we got a game six, and I would love to see a game seven, too.
Touch on the Durant injury, if you could. You've experienced injury in your career. When you saw it happen, what were your initial thoughts? And now that you know ruptured Achilles, that'll keep him out, you know, for an extended period of time at this point in his career. As a, you know, again, former player, what were your thoughts?
Listen, your heart breaks. It really does. It started with a calf strain, which are pretty serious injuries, and you never know how it involves with the Achilles. And he was out for 32 days. So when you think of calf strains, normally you can come back and heal from those. But I don't know what the risks were with him coming back. I don't know what percentage he was as far as his health. He made his first three shots in the game, and he was making a big impact when he was out there. But it's just really unfortunate for him. He's one of the best players in the world, top two or three players in the world. He is 31 years old. Recovering from that injury is not going to be easy. But with his body type, with his elasticity, I anticipate he's going to come back and he's going to be okay with technology after this Achilles injury. But it is a long recovery. It is a long rehab. And I don't wish that on anyone, having gone through a bunch of surgeries.
Wally, two questions here. First off, who do you think is going to win the series? And secondly, who's the key for the Raptors to win if they are to win the series?
I think the Raptors are going to win the series. I just think without Kevin Durant, it's going to be an uphill battle for Golden State. Obviously, Klay Thompson and Steph Curry were tremendous down the stretch in that game, and they made the big plays to steal that game in Toronto. But Toronto has pretty much a full deck, and when you have all your weapons, all your options, you kind of go into games where you kind of feel like this is our game to lose, and we should win this game, and we should win this series. And the key for me is Pascal Siakam. I think he's looked a little bit not as confident as we saw him in the regular season, especially from the perimeter. I think he needs a little bit of a matchup advantage out there. I think when he gets a matchup like that, when Boogie Cousins is on him, he can use his foot speed, and he can get to the basket, he can get out and transition. But without Kevin Durant out there, I thought he was a guy who could really neutralize Siakam and make his life difficult. But now with Durant out of the lineup, Siakam becomes one of those kind of X-factor guys that I think his game is going to elevate in these last two games. So I think he's a big key for the Raptors, because you know what you're going to get from a lot of the other guys like Leonard and Marc Gasol. And, you know, Lowry struggled last game with his shooting, but, you know, he's probably not going to do that in Game 6 and Game 7. So if Siakam steps up, I think it's game, set, match, and the Raptors win.
And, Wally, to me, in watching the finals, a lot has been surrounding the post play. Gasol, Siakam, you're talking Cousins. How pivotal is it for Cousins to kind of be that X factor as well as Siakam on the other side?
Well, he's my X factor exactly, Jules, for Golden State. Because if you noticed, he wasn't even playing when Kevin Durant was out there. So they had their schemes and they had their lineup set and their point of attack and their scouting report to attack Toronto with Kevin Durant out there and not be playing Cousins. But then when Kevin Durant got hurt, Cousins became a focal point, and he played great. And he shot the ball well, hit that big three that we're seeing there, made some big plays down low and inside. So in order for Golden State to come back and continue this comeback, he's got to play big. He's got to continue to play the way he did right when he got inserted into the lineup in Game 5. And if he plays like all-star DeMarcus Cousins and he kind of turns back the clock from last year and years previous, then I give Golden State a chance to pull off this series. But he, to me, is the absolute key, because he's going to get big minutes. He's got to dominate his matchup with Marc Gasol, and he's got to kind of fill that void without Kevin Durant out there, picking up the scoring load especially.
Now, I have useless stats for you. Do you want it for the Raptors or for the Warriors?
I love useless stats, because then I can just tell them how useless they are. Tell you how useless they are.
Well, which one do you
he
want?
He loves stats.
Pick one. I want them all. Throw them
you want
line.
Them all?
Start with the Raptors.
All right. Your key player for the Warriors is Klay Thompson, because he's great in game sixes historically. Against Houston, he had 27, hit 7 threes. Last year against Houston in Game 6, he hit 9 threes, went for 35. And back in 2016 in Western Conference Finals against the Thunder, he went for 41 and he hit a record 11 threes. What do you think about that?
play.
I remember those games. That performance against the Thunder on the road was heroic. It really was. That 11-3 performance, he would not let his team lose. The problem is he already made seven threes in the last game. So you don't think Toronto's going to adjust and they're not going to take him out of their game plan and their focal point of their defense is not going to be allowing him to make those seven threes? It's a different dynamic coming off adjustments in different games. That's my only argument as far as those stats go. But those are impressive stats. And Klay Thompson, he plays his best basketball when his back is against the wall and his team is against the wall, for sure.
You know, by the way, before you say anything, Jules, we need to save that because he liked my stat there.
He liked it. He liked it.
But let's revisit this game six, Alan Hahn. I don't think it's going to come up with a big
game. I know you won't let me forget, that's for sure.
And Wally, how much do you think the emotion, though, of it being the last game at Oracle Arena, all this Kevin Durant injury stuff, how much do you think the Warriors can hang on emotion and adrenaline in this one?
That's a good one. I'll tell you. The guy that can neutralize the emotion in that arena is Kawhi Leonard because he has no emotion and he just plays his game. And the Raptors are going to have to follow that lead. They can't get too high. They can't get too low. I think they have the feeling where they kind of gave away game five. They had it. They had a lead coming down the stretch. I didn't understand the timeout. I didn't understand some of the play calls. And they allowed Steph Curry and Klay Thompson to win that game for them. But they can't. They can't remember that. They got to just forget about that. They got to move on to game six. They got to put that game behind them. And they got to figure out a way to try to steal game six on the road in a hostile environment. They've done it before, but they need a full-time team effort. They need everyone making shots. They need everyone stepping up. They need everyone playing their roles. And then they need their stars playing like stars. So it's going to be a crazy environment. But one thing Golden State doesn't have is they don't have one of their huge weapons, and that's Kevin Durant. And Toronto knows that. And when you're a team that knows that, you play with a little bit more confidence. You play with a little bit more swagger when you know that the team you're playing doesn't have one of their best players. So that's going to be something that keep an eye on some of those guys taking and making shots that normally they wouldn't when maybe Kevin Durant was in the lineup.
For more great videos from the MSG 150, check out right there. And remember, our show is on Monday through Thursday, 8 to 10:30 p.m. on MSG Network and MSG Go.